I thought I was going to be here for a day and work out, but I've been here since Wednesday.
Masters!
Well, Danielle will be happy.
Hi there,
Hello, Brother Kurt. David, I believe, is your name.
Your middle name.
Right? Yeah. I told him I wouldn't forget that.
What time is Mom getting?
Maybe around 8.
I thought you were
coming
back.
Probably should bring him in the house. They didn't need me after all, so I stayed home. I thought you were going to go pick her up, though, anyway.
Danny.
No, she's kind of...
Get the kids on the rail.
Do it. Oh. So far, so good.
She
keeps testing
me
every couple hours.
I hope it's
just
warm tomorrow.
Yes, it is.
I hope it's just sunny today.
Is the floor down around? It's 11, around 11?
Like this, yeah, probably. Matt West said she could do it in 10, but
he's going to do that.
I don't know. I haven't been watching the weather.
Well, all week long, there's supposed to be clouds and lightning bolts all week, Monday through Saturday.
That's a lot of work.
Drive at
the Pittsburgh by a couple hours.
Hold off one more day. He's healthy.
Stand up.
It's time to stand up, folks.
Oh, say, can you see? What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets reckless.
Amen.
Okay, Linda, you join in the kids and they lead us into the Pledge of Allegiance.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lord, we thank you for this beautiful day you've given, for each of these young faces that we have here. They're ready to ride. We ask your blessing, Lord, that they keep safe on horses like they have all week. May it honor you and bring glory to you as they ride their horses. And we ask this, Jesus, in your name.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated. Give me a second to get wired.
She goes to the city school.
No, she's older. She's a child.
Can they come way up here?
In the summer, to do counseling.
The word cowboy has stood for independence, honesty, and freedom for more than 100 years. It brings to mind a campfire on a starry night. Now, we've had campfires, but riding the range with the wind in your face, for conquering a ton of bucking bull for 8 seconds. Whether that's you getting down on that rock in the chute and back into a roping box by a working cowboy making his living, and maybe watching your favorite Western movie on vacation, enjoying a ride, or just pulling on your boots and go to that rodeo. If you have, you felt the cowboy spirit. Kids of all ages dream of being a cowboy. No time box to punch, no test in school, no concrete jungles or high-rise buildings, no blaring horns, no traffic jams. Just a good horse in wide open spaces. Cowboy is an attitude, a mindset. It's a return to simpler times, where the rich smell of dirt behind a plow, or the aroma of a new batch of grain at the feed store was all you needed. The time when a man's life stood behind his handshake and his word was good as money in the bank. Looking for the way, the cowboy spirit. This is out of a cowboy Bible. I don't know if you knew there was such a thing, New Testament. And we have these, and they get a lot of testimonies of cowboys in them. I'm going to share one other verse here in Psalms 103. Praise the Lord, my soul, and all that is in me. Praise his holy name. Praise the name of the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases. Who redeems your life from the pit and crowns you with love and compassion. Who satisfies your desires with good things so that in your youth is renewed like eagles. We praise God for the blessing of a week that we called for rain all week. We had more rain here. And the kids had a good time to be able to ride and enjoy the horses. And today you're going to see that. They're getting ready to come on in. What they're going to do, I'll just give you an example, a little bit of what they're going. This is basically a trail class like you might see at the fair, only it's in a condensed version. The kids are fairly at different ages, and some of them have challenged. We're challenged with their horses and worked on their horsemanship skills and did really well. Some are still learning and working. And so some have been able to do some trotting and cantering, and some will just walk the pattern. Bailey's coming in on Cody, and she's going to be our first guinea pig. They have never ridden this pattern ever this week. They have done most of these things, so this is going to be a challenge to work with their horse to get them to do work together and do neat things. She's going to turn that cone and ask her horse to go in and out of turn the drum and have the horses go in out of the cones. As the kids get a little older, a little more practice, we do that at a trot. And it's a little more challenging. When she turns that last drum, she's going to ask her horse to either trot, walk, or canter. And I'll be surprised to see which one happens. Cody is a Missouri Fox Trotter. He's one of the kids' favorite horses, especially when we get near water. That horse loves to stick his head in water trough and blow bubbles, play in the river. He splashes other horses. As Bailey brings Cody through the L pattern, I'm going to ask her to dismount in a special way. We call this the squirrel, but it's really emergency dismount. It's where they kick their feet out of their skirts, drop the reins, and bowl out the horse and land next to the horse. You won't land on the board. But Bailey, we caught a big old horse fly bothering your horse, and he was getting a little wild, so I said squirrel off that horse. Okay, let's give Bailey a hand.